Welcome back to the PTV Vistro training web series. I am excited to take you for a tour of Vistro's well-organized Graphical User Interface, or GUI, in this two-part episode. Have you experienced overwhelming and cluttered GUIs? You know, those other programs that fill up your entire screen with confusing icons and endless ribbons, making your workable space tiny? Well, with PTV Vistro, we give you a sleek, modern GUI planned out for your optimal performance. We thoughtfully loaded Vistro with helpful icons and features that provides you with intuitive workflow. In this video, part one, I will be describing what the buttons and tools can do on the menu bar, status bar, and main toolbars. In part two, I will cover the workflow panel, data window, and my favorite shortcuts. Later on in the series, I will show you how all of these powerful features are applied to build and analyze your Vistro network. First, let's go over the menu bar and status bar. When I open a new instance of Vistro, I see our friendly Bing base map and PTV start page. On the start page, we can see Vistro highlights, service pack information, and release information, as well as links to this video web series. To click off the start page, we can select an element on the workflow panel or just start coding an intersection. Then the data window will appear. Up on the top left, we see the menu bar, which contains the file dropdown. This dropdown contains the standard New, Open, and Save As buttons. Also, there is the powerful Print Report button. And here, you can set up report features. Tip number one, once you set up a report with custom headers and settings, then you can save the file as your local custom template to use on your next Vistro project. Tip number two, set your print report options in your base scenario so your customizations carry to future scenarios. Then lastly, we have the import and export buttons. Here you can import from PTV Vsum or Transsoft's Otis. Also, there is a volume import function under values where you can upload a CSV file of volume information. In export, we can convert to PTV Vsum and Otis, export our volume data under values, and also export the current scenario as a new Vistro file. And there's no need for a Vsum conversion because Vsum will directly import a Vistro file. What about Synchro? With PTV Vistro, you can import and export Synchro CSV files. So if you have those old Synchro models laying around, you can easily upgrade to Vistro. Next, we have an edit dropdown containing another way to undo and redo things. But down on the bottom is global defaults. Global defaults can set up your local agency information and preferences. It's very important that you set these defaults up prior to coding intersections. And much like print reports, once global defaults are set up for your local agency requirements, it's a good idea to hit that save button to make a template. Moving on to the view dropdown, we have the network statistic button to let you know how large your network is. Then there is a switch table position button, which moves the workflow panel to the bottom of the screen and back again. And finally, the message and log file button. With these buttons, you can check the status of your project, review errors, and results during optimization procedures. On the signal control dropdown, you can create default signalization for all intersections. This is different than the local intersection option under the traffic control workflow button that will be discussed in part two. Next, we have local and network signal optimization options. And at the bottom, we have the edit coordination groups button. This button will allow you to create and modify coordination groups in your network. A coordination group is a collection of signal controllers, such as along a corridor or in a neighborhood, that would be coordinated together. Over to the right, we have the simulation dropdown. And here, you can preview your Vistro network in Vsum, or convert it to VISM using the same A&M tool listed under the export option. Of course, we have our help dropdown with great links to the manual, service pack updates, tech support, examples, and documentation. Next to the help, we have the main undo and redo buttons, and then the scenario manager list. Here with this dropdown, you can select the base scenario or select and rename any created scenarios, all in one Vistro file. Below the scenario manager, we have our view buttons to window zoom and zoom extents, as well as the zoom slider, or you could just use the mouse wheel to zoom. Between the zoom buttons, we have the map layers dropdown. Here, you can turn your network objects on and off, or the internet map on and off. As you hover over the internet map, you have the ability to select various Bing map options and open street maps. Also, here you can use the slider to change the map opacity. At the bottom, the Insert Background button will let you place a custom image file into the model and scale it by dragging the corners. You can also set the precise measurement using the ruler icon. Then drag the scaler from point to point, type in the value, and then move your image into the correct spot. Now up in the top right corner is the Intersection Selection dropdown. This useful sortable list, by clicking on the header or typing in an intersection name or number, will allow you to quickly pull up those intersection details on larger models. And finally, on the bottom left corner, we have the status bar. This area will display a real-time scale ratio and real XY coordinates of the mouse in the network area. Meaning if you zoom to Greenwich Park in southeast London, your X coordinate will go to zero when you find the prime meridian. These coordinates are important because if you use the internet maps for your network location, it will be synced across PTV Visum and PTV Visum platforms. Next, let's focus on the left side of the screen to view the features in the main toolbar. The first five boxes are network tools used to create network elements. The last nine boxes are in the graphic selector tools and are used to toggle data displays. The graphic selector tools are ordered by lane group details, intersection details, and approach details. In-depth descriptions of these buttons are listed in section 5.1.3 and 5.1.5 of the PDF user manual. Here on the main toolbar, I am starting with the intersection configuration button. And for all the buttons with the little arrow, you can click underneath to open up a submenu. By opening up the arrow, we see that we have all-way stop, two-way stop, roundabouts, and the one with the question mark is unknown. The unknown type can be used anywhere that you don't want an analysis, and perhaps this intersection is used to distribute traffic only. Next are the traffic zone and gate buttons. Zone and gates are origin destination elements needed to develop and distribute site traffic. A zone is a location that can generate additional or reduced traffic to the base volume. Think of this as a place where a new development site is located or an old development site is removed. A gate is a location where the zone traffic goes to when leaving a zone, or comes from when entering a zone. Next is the path button. A path connects a gate to a zone, or a zone to a gate, or a zone to a zone, but it cannot connect a gate to a gate. To draw a path, click on the start zone or gate symbol, and trace the dotted line to the small circle on the starting leg. Then click the small blue circle on the destination leg, and finally end the destination on the zone or gate symbol. To edit a path, click on the intermediate point represented by the gray push pin and drag to a new intersection location. Below Path is the Route button. This button is used to develop traffic signal offset optimization. You can draw a route along a corridor or around an intersection corner to optimize a custom route. Similar to a path, to draw a route, click on the starting location and then click on the end location. The route can be edited by dragging the gray push pins. Now in the lane group detail area, the first button is for showing turn movements. Here you can turn on graphical volume arrows displaying a variety of volume types. For more information on definitions of these volume sets and calculations, see the PTV user manual under section 8.2, table 6. The next button shows signal groups for each approach. This is a great tool to visually error check your model and help design the intersection signal controller. This button shows traffic conditions and is another great visual tool that will colorfully display your lane group's level of service, delay, and volume to capacity ratios right on your network. Moving on to the intersection detail area, the next button is Show Intersection Info. This button can display a variety of useful intersection information, such as colorful level of service grades, traffic control type icons, coordination groups, and an ICA check. An ICA check reviews if your intersection coding is sufficient to perform intersection capacity analysis and provides you with another great tool to quickly error check your model. This next function, Show Traffic Condition, gives you a nice pop-up display of your intersection delay, level of service, and volume to capacity ratio. Moving down to the Approach Details area, the first button is the Show Unbalanced Flows button. This button will provide in and out approach volume on each link and will quickly highlight the areas that require volume balancing in red and balance volumes in green. This is a very powerful tool, especially if you plan to convert to VISM and need balanced volumes. The next button is Queue Length. This will graphically display the max queue length on your network to key you in on potential intersection spillbacks or short turn lanes. Below Queue Length is the Street Name button. This button will display the street names on legs that you have activated in the intersection setup workflow. And finally, the Approach Traffic Conditions button provides a summary on the approach leg of delays, V over C, and level of service.
Wow, that's a lot of great tools and features. You should now know how to navigate through the menu bar, status bar, and main toolbar. And you should know what buttons create network elements. You should also know how to turn on and off your favorite graphical displays. This concludes part 1 of PTV Vistro's user interface. Make sure that you watch part 2 to learn about the workflow panel, data windows, and my favorite shortcuts.
Please subscribe so you don't miss a moment of this web series. If you have a comment or a Vistro question, please connect with me on the LinkedIn PTV Vistro forum. Streamline your traffic engineering or transportation planning study efforts with PTV Vistro.